Guys, check this out. This is a great find. It's an Osterizer blender. And the thing with this one here is, check it out. They went 10 bucks for it. This is the old one. Right there, you can see it. Made in the USA. Wisconsin. Milwaukee. And that is the real deal. Now we're gonna plug them in and check it out. Doo-doo-doo. Hopefully it don't suck. All right. And this has the little, this has just a little thingy, the knob. Ooh. That is all good all day long. Look at that. Coming home with me. All right, cool. Off I go. Yay! Hey guys, I did some homework on this Osterizer, and it is the it's the Beehive one. Model 235 Series A. This is it. That sold. One of them sold on what is this? Poshmark or something, or Etsy? I don't know what the hell you are. What are you? Oh, it's on Etsy. And so it sold. But this thing here's got a motor in it, and it's I played it for you. So, and this is the Beehive. So, I might actually even keep this damn thing. Oh, don't be a hoarder. But. Made my day, so I don't know if I'm gonna sell it or not, but it polished up really good, and for 10 bucks, they don't make them like this anymore. All right, cool. Now off I go. Hopefully I gotta put all this video together. Beep. Enjoy the show, or whatever you do. Yay. Hey guys, it's me again, Don Kiker, and I got that little Osterizer. I just got it home, and I'm looking over. It's really dirty, but I have checked it all out. It's got some funk down in here, and I came outside because it's really nice out today, and it's super sunny. And I wanted to show you again on the bottom. Oh, he's upside down. Yeah, this is the John Oster Manufacturing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin, made in the USA. I love that made in the USA. Love it. And this is the Model 235 Series A, and going into the other jazz over there, and over here. Is one or more of the following parts applied. This also has the up here for the juicer attachment. So this is going to hit a lot of other points. And so this is what I'm doing. I am going to clean it up. It is rock solid and it is really heavy. It's got a great motor, and I played the video and it sounds great. Everybody's here, and I'm going to clean them up. So let's get, I have my turtle wax, chrome polish, and rust remover with my quadruple odd steel wool. So let's get ready to get into this thing, and I'm gonna start and do it. Okay guys, let's get into it. Gotta shake this up. Okay, now I got my rag. Let's go clean him up. This thing is doing it, boy. Woo! Look at how shiny this thing is. It gets the pits out, get all the funk out, for the most part. I mean, this thing's awesome. I can't believe it.
Look at its shine. Wow. That's got a nice shine on it. What a great vintage piece. And this thing will last another 50, 60 years easily if you don't destroy it. That's as far as I'm going to go. I'm not going to go any further and put any funky stuff on it. So for all intent and purpose, this is done. And now I have to do this. And the blades on this are really sharp. I don't even think this was ever even used. So I have to find another gasket. I think I have a bag of them somewhere. So yeah. It says rubber ring. There is no rubber ring, but that's not an issue really at all because they do make them. All right, so now let's clean this guy here up. Put this over here. Now we're going to do this. Actually get this. Okay guys, so for all intent and purpose, I have to wash this guy here off. I'm going to put this back on. It's all the way in the off mode. Put this guy back on. Everything's got to get washed. So, there you go. I think it turned out pretty damn good. Very shiny. Yeah, it shows a little bit of signs. I'm gonna signs of stuff over here, but that's just a quick little polish, and this is what you get. That is just absolutely a beautiful Osterizer, and there you go. Yay! And off I go. Oh yeah, thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. I still need 1,000 more subscribers or something like that. Anyway, have fun out there. Be safe. Beep. Up I go.